Before we start our lesson, I want to know from you the importance of today. Do you see anything specific regarding this day? Today,
Saturday is involved.
Sir, 9/11.
9? 9/11?
Sir, involved.
Yeah, it is 9/11, but what is the importance? Yes, let me tell. Yes, who was there? Valde?
Sir,
Yes, it
involved.
is. Yeah, it is Iqbal Day. Yes, that's what I wanted to Abdul Rafi. Yes, it is
Yes,
Iqbal
sir,
Day.
sir, come
So,
on.
okay. If you raise hand, then I can see who is there because your name then will appear on the top. But anyways, I hope now you all know that today is Iqbal Day. So that's the one thing, right? 9th of November. What is Iqbal Day? Why do we call it Iqbal Day?
Is it because Allama Iqbal was born on this day?
On this day, okay, good. Do you know the year? When was he born? In which year he was born? Okay, I can tell you, 1877. 18. When was he born?
77.
1877.
1877. So 9th of November, 1877. So where was he born?
Sir, in Karachi.
Sialkot.
Sialkot, sir.
Sialkot. Karachi was Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was born. Okay. So he was
Yes.
born in Sialkot, in Punjab. In the time of, like we can say, British India. Okay, so what do you know about him? Anything? I mean, you might be knowing a lot of things about, but anything in specific you know about him? So you can raise your hand, and I can, call your name then. Yes, Abdurrahman.
Sir, I know about his death. He was died on 21st of April 1938.
Salama Iqbal passed away, died on 21st of April 1938 in Lahore. Yes. Okay. So, what do you know about him otherwise, Salama Iqbal? Anyone else? Anyone else?
Sir,
Anything
his
in.
father name was Muhammad.
His father name was?
Sheikh Muhammad.
Sheikh Muhammad. Okay.
Sir,
Do you
he
know?
was a great poet.
Okay, good. That's what I wanted to know from you, that do you know about him? That if we are saying this is Iqbal Day and we are celebrating this is as Iqbal Day, on campus, we used to hold a proper function for this day, on this day,
There is.
and used to have speeches, and then from the students, from the teachers, from the coordinators and principals and etc. So why do we do that?
There is early poetry was in Persian.
He wrote in Persian and in Urdu as well.
He was called the poet
Sir,
of
but
East.
most of his famous poetry was in Persian, Farsi.
Yeah, he actually, we say that he wrote in Persian in simple way and in Urdu as well.
So can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
Sir, was it Sayyid Ahmed Khan and Sir Sayyid Muhammad Iqbal same?
No. He is Sir Dr. Allama Muhammad Iqbal, right? And he was born 1877, as we just, one of you told me, and we discussed this. Whereas Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan, what we just finished talking about, we were talking about this topic, Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. So he was born 1817 in Delhi. And though they shared a little bit time, he was born on 1877, and Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan died in 1898. So there is a little bit shared period of time, but Allama Iqbal was then so young, and he was still to rise to the level of Dr. Allama Muhammad Iqbal. That's why we know him. Anyways, so yes,
as a Pakistani, we celebrate this because he had a dream of Pakistan, and he convinced Qaid Azam calling him from England. Then Qaid Azam came to Pakistan, and then he convinced him.
Yes, he had a lot of contribution. So what we say generally about Dr. Allama Muhammad Iqbal, he is our national poet, you should know, our national poet. So if there is any question somewhere, who is our national poet? So it is Sir Dr. Allama Muhammad Iqbal. So contribution of Allama is immense, is huge, you know, in politics, in the revival of Muslims and Islam, and influencing people in general and the leaders also. He was not just like a routine type of a politician or a poet or a philosopher. He was a renowned philosopher as well. So he had a big influence on the people, and he had an influence on the people like Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. As one of you mentioned, that he actually convinced Qaid Azam, who went on a sort of voluntary exile in 30s. So Allama convinced Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah to come back and lead the Muslims. So what we know is that he had a big influence overall on the Muslims and on the leaders as well. So his, cutting it short, major contribution of Allama Iqbal, he was a politician too, so he led in politics, where somebody said that he dreamt Pakistan. It was 1930 when? It was 1930 when in Lucknow, Allahabad, a city in India, Allahabad, he was addressing Muslim League annual meeting, in which he discussed, in which he told the people what he kind of predicted, that it appears to me to be the final destiny of the Muslims of India to have a separate homeland for them, at least of Northwest Muslim of India, and that is what Pakistan we have today. So in 1930, he actually kind of looking into future, he told at that point the people who were there that to me it appears to be the final destiny. Like, I see this for you guys. It was like telling them that I may not be there, but I see this for you guys, the separate homeland, at least of Northwestern Muslim of India, which is Pakistan now. So that is why we call him the one who actually dreamt Pakistan, had a dream of Pakistan. It was not a dream like what I usually refer to while somebody sees something and while sleeping. It was well thought, well actually predicted, and people with intellect and wisdom and knowledge, they see the things the way things are happening at the present, they can actually predict about the future. So it is not about any sort of prediction in a common sense. It is intellectual vision, why we call him a visionary poet. So he saw that this would happen. So that is why we called him the one who dreamed Pakistan, about Pakistan, a separate homeland for the Muslim of India. Apart from them, he influenced great politicians. I mentioned Qaid Azam Mohammad Ali Jinnah. He convinced him, and Qaid Azam honored him, and he came back. Qaid Azam had a great respect for Allama Iqbal. Once he said that if I'll be given an option, if I'll be given an what? Option. And what is the option? That if I'll be offered that, Mr. Jinnah, you can have a big empire, which is not just a country, an empire, and you know empires consist of many countries, like British Empire and Ottoman Empire, ruling a large area. So if I'm offered an empire, and if I'm on the other side, the second option, I'll be given Allama Iqbal. So if I'll be told to choose one, you want empire or Allama Iqbal, so I will go for Allama Iqbal. And in 1940, when we passed Pakistan Resolution, you know, what we celebrate as Pakistan Day, in which after 10 years, Muslim League demanded this separate homeland. Allama Iqbal told them in 1930, so in 40 they demanded actually. They officially, Muslim League said that we want separate homeland. So on this day, when this Lahore resolution was passed, so Qaid Azam remembered Allama Iqbal, because Allama Iqbal was passed away in 1938, as you told now, 21st of April 1938 in Lahore, he died, he passed away. So in 40, when in March Lahore resolution was passed, so after 2 years almost, so Qaid Azam said that had Allama been alive today, he would have been happy to see us doing what he wanted us to do. So today, it was a great tribute by Qaid Azam to Allama Iqbal, that even after his death, Qaid Azam remembered him, and he said that we are doing what he told us to do. So this was his influence. His poetry, now coming back to his poetry. His poetry, which is mainly consist of four major books, right? His old poetry is what? His poetry is full of wisdom. It is not just a poetry like what you see in on Facebook and elsewhere. No, it's not like that. It's a poetry of wisdom, guidance, light, and hope in very simple words. If you want, today people are worried about that we don't know, like they don't have actually sort of guidance. So read Allama Iqbal. People are like kind of lost and hopelessness and despair and frustration and depression. Read Allama Iqbal. If you want light, if you want guidance, if you want hope, if you want passion, if you want purpose in life, read Allama Iqbal. His poetry is full of this guidance, and he drives people to rise above the level. That Allama even says that sitaron se aage jahan aur bhi hain. Mean, don't see what you can see physical. There is world beyond that. And his love for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was exemplary. He was a great devotee, what we called a very staunch follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he was in a strong belief that whatever is in this world and universe, it is because of him, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that is why he, in his poetry is full of the praise of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In one of his words, he said that ki Muhammad se wafa tu ne to hum tere hain. If you are honest, and if you are a true follower of Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to hum tere hain. This is sort of message from Allah Almighty. Seki Muhammad se wafa tu ne to hum tere hain. ये जहाँ चीज है क्या लोहो कलम तेरे. मीन ट्रांसलेट आई एम ट्रांसलेटिंग इफ यू आर एन ऑनेस्ट ट्रू फॉलोअर ऑफ द प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम गॉड सेज आई एम विद यू एंड यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड. ये जहाँ चीज है क्या यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वर्ल्ड. आई विल गिव यू वट लोहो कलम. लोहो कलम वट वी बिलीव इन वेयर ऑल थिंग्स आर रिटन बाय अल्लाह ऑलमाइटी वट वी कॉल तकदीर डेस्टनी. सो गॉड सेज आई विल गिव यू द कलम आई विल गिव यू द लो एंड यू कैन राइट वट एवर यू वॉन्ट. सो मीन दैट डोंट बी वरी अबाउट दिस 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 टाइनी स्मॉल वर्ल्ड एंड यू नो अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइंस आर अर्थ प्लैनेट इज जस्ट अ स्पैक अ स्मॉल डॉट इन द एंटायर यूनिवर्स. सो इट इज लाइक अ सैंड पार्टिकल. इट इज दिस मच इन द एंटायर यूनिवर्स. वैल्यू और इफ यू से द प्लेस ऑफ द अर्थ प्लैनेट जस्ट अ स्पैक. सो गॉड सेज दैट यू थिंक ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड आई गिव यू लो कलम आई गिव यू कलम आई गिव यू लो एंड यू राइट व्हाट यू वांट. सो हिज पोएट्री इज फुल ऑफ मैसेज लाइक इन दिस ओनली इन दिस वन वर्ड्स ही समराइजेज द होल क्रक्स ऑफ इस्लाम द स्पिरिट ऑफ इस्लाम. कि मोहम्मद से वफा तूने तो हम तेरे हैं ये जहाँ चीज़ है क्या लोहो कलम तेरे हैं. गॉड सेज दैट आई विल गिव यू एवरीथिंग नॉट ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड डोंट थिंक ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड आई विल गिव यू कलम एंड राइट वट एवर यू वॉन्ट. सो हिज मैसेज इज फुल ऑफ करेज फुल ऑफ स्पिरिट. इन अनदर वर्ड्स एंड आई विल एंड विद दिस इन अनदर वर्ड्स ही सेड दैट ये गाजी ये तेरे पुरसरार बंदे जिन्हें तूने बख्शा है जोके खुदाई दो नीम इनकी ठोकर से सहरा और दरिया समट कर पहाड़ इनकी हैबत सिराई. आई ट्रांसलेट दिस. ये क्या था और इज इट ये गाजी ये तेरे पुरसरार बंदे. गाजी वी नो द पर्सन हु कम्स बैक फ्रॉम लाइक फाइटिंग द वॉर. सो here Iqbal says that ye ghazi ye tere purasrar bande any people who have a purpose in life and they are ready to sacrifice whatever it takes to succeed. So be it great generals, be it great intellectuals, be it great people who serve humanity. So they are all that. You can take the name of Abdul Sattar Eidi, or you can take the name of Tariq bin Ziyad, or you can take name of anyone who has done something great in the true spirit. So ye ghazi ye tere purasrar bande. Alama says that they have something hidden in them. Purasrar mean which has something special. So they have something special in them. Ye ghazi ye tere purasrar bande jinhe tune bakhsha hai zoke khudai. And they act like that they are the master of their fate and everything around. Do neem inki thokar se sehra aur darya. If they thokar mean jaise hum urdu mein kehte hain ki paon se kisi cheez ko kick marte hain to usko thokar kehte hain. So do neem mean ke jhuk jati hai jo cheez bhi na aise jaise hum ruku karte hain ya sajda karte hain koi cheez jhuk jati hai. To wo kehte hain ki inki ek thokar se सहरा और दरिया झुक जाते हैं. यानी दो नीम इनकी इनकी ठोकर से सहरा और दरिया यानी इनके पाँव के नीचे है चाहे वो सहरा हो चाहे दरिया हो. समट कर पहाड़ इनकी हैबत से राई. ये जो माउंटेन्स हैं पहाड़ हैं इतने बड़े बड़े तो इनके खौफ से इन ये जो लोग हैं स्पेशल पर्पस जिन्होंने अपनी ज़िंदगी में कुछ अपना लिया तो इनके खौफ से जो पहाड़ है वो राई हो जाता है. राई जो रेत का बारीक से बारीक ज़रा होता है ना जिसको हम सेपरेट भी नहीं कर सकते सम टाइम तो उसको राई कहते हैं. तो वो कहते हैं कि समट कर पहाड़ इनकी हैबत से राई यानी इनको देख के पहाड़ कांप रहे होते हैं. तो ये व्हाट इफ वी समराइज होल ऑफ दिस जस्ट वन वन व्हाट वी कॉल अ वर्ड्स ये दो शेर हैं इनको अगर हम समराइज करें तो इसका मतलब ये है कि अल्लाह ताला ने इकबाल हमें कन्विंस कर रहा है कि अल्लाह ताला ने इंसान को इतनी ताकत दी है कि अगर वो अपने मकसद को पहचान ले एंड आइडेंटिफाई द ट्रू स्पिरिट इन लाइफ, और वो क्या है कि वो अल्लाह और उसके रसूल के हुक्म को मानना है, तो उसको इतनी ताकत, इतनी पावर मिल जाती है कि फिर ये जो सामने जो हमें छोटी छोटी मुश्किलात नज़र आती हैं, वो ये जो सहरा, दरिया और पहाड़ हैं, ये सिंबलिज्म है यहाँ पे कि जो इंसान फेस कर सकता है। ये यही हमारे नज़र के सामने तो यही बड़ी चीज़ है ना, या सहरा होगा या दरिया होगा या पहाड़ होंगे अगर आप मुश्किल की बात करते हैं। तो वो कहते हैं कि ये तो इनके सामने ऐसे काम पड़े होते हैं, यानी अगर इंसान अपने खुदा और रसूल के सही मैसेज को अपना लेता है और ज़िंदगी में एक बड़ा मकसद बना लेता है और फिर उसके सामने कोई चीज़ नहीं टिकती, तो वो फिर बिकम्स तारिक बिन ज़ियाद, यू नो कि जब उन्होंने मेडिटेरेनियन, ही क्रॉस मेडिटेरेनियन एंड लैंडेड इन स्पेन, सो ही बर्नड हिज बोट्स, सो हिज आर्मी वॉज शॉक्ड दैट व्हाट डिड यू डू, वी आर सो लेस इन नंबर्स एंड द एनमी इज सो पावरफुल, सो ही टोल्ड देम लुक इन फ्रंट इज योर एनमी, बैक इज द मेडिटेरेनियन सी, देयर इज अ सी बैक, now there is a death on the both side, in front the enemy, back the sea, if you run back you will be drawn, if you go and do not fight war you will be killed by the enemy, so what is left for you to live, go and win. To phir it is in the history that those handful of Muslim, less in number, they defeated Spain and then Muslim ruled in Europe for 700 years. So ye spirit, this is what Allama Iqbal says. And even at this point, Allama Iqbal said that Tariq bin Ziyad, when he burnt the boats, so his people were shocked. So he told them, Har mulk milke maast, ki har mulk milke khudaast, ki har mulk mera mulk hai, ki har mulk mere khuda ka mulk hai. It's a Persian verse. तो अल्लामा इक़बाल ने तारिक बिन ज़ियाद की ज़बान में कि उसने अपने सिपाहियों को बताया कि देखो यही अब तुम्हारा मुल्क है, यहाँ पे तुमने मरना है, यहीं पे तुमने ज़िंदा रहना है, ऑप्शन कोई नहीं है, यू नीड टू गो फाइट एंड डिफीट एंड लिव और डाई, सो दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ ही वांटेड एंड ही एड्रेस्ड मुस्लिम यूथ, हिज टॉपिक, हिज एड्रेस was always Muslim youth, and that's why he used the word Shaheen. Shaheen is a symbol what Allama used for Muslim youth. So he wanted the Muslim youth to be like this Shaheen symbolically. Now there are three characteristics of Shaheen, what Allama wanted that the Muslim youth should be like. One, that it fly high. Shaheen flies high. Number two, he is so we call in Urdu jo apne upar confidence, self confidence hai ya khuddar hai, ke never eat anything which is hunted by someone else, so wo koi murda ya mara hua shikar wo nahi karta, hunt himself. And thirdly, lives make no nest, wo koi ghonsla nahi banata, wo इतना यानी उसका तवक्कल है अल्लाह ताला की ज़ात पे कि वो बस पहाड़ों की चट्टानों में, तू है शाहीन बसेरा कर पहाड़ों की चट्टानों में, तो वो अल्लामा इकबाल कहते हैं कि नहीं तेरा नशेमन कसर सुल्तानी के गुंबद पर, कसर सुल्तानी यानी जो बादशाह का महल होता है उसका जो गुंबद होता है ऊपर, जो बड़े बड़े महलात में बने होते हैं, तो वहाँ पर परिंदे अपना घोंसले बना लेते हैं, तो अल्लामा इकबाल कहते हैं शाहीन को, यानी ये एक्चुअली वो मुसलमान से बात कर रहे हैं, मुस्लिम यूथ से बात कर रहे हैं कि नहीं तेरा नशेमन कसर सुल्तानी के गुंबद पर, नशेमन मतलब टिकाना, रहने की जगह, तो तुम्हारे रहने की जगह जो है वो सुल्तान जो बादशाह है उसका जो कसर है, जो महल है, उसका जो गुंबद है वो नहीं है, तू है शाहीन बसेरा कर पहाड़ों की चट्टानों में, तू तो शाहीन है, तू तो पहाड़ों की चट्टानों पर बसेरा करे, यानी यू आर फ्री and away from these things. So ye Allama Iqbal ka message hai, or he was a great individual, God blessed him with this great intellect and wisdom which he spread for us, which he left for us through his poetry. So his poetry koi aam poetry, shayari nahi hai, वो एक स्पिरिट है, एक मैसेज है, एक लाइट है, एक होप है, अवेकनिंग है, अवेयरनेस है, फ्यूचर है. अलामा इकबाल की पोइट्री हमेशा इट विल बी फ्यूचरिस्टिक. कोई भी वक्त होगा, कोई भी चीज़ होगी, अलामा इकबाल उस वक्त से आगे की बात कर रहे होते हैं. तुम इससे भी आगे जाओ. सो वी आर ग्रेटली इंडेप्टेड टू अलामा मोहम्मद इकबाल फॉर हिज विजन, फॉर हिज लव फॉर ह्यूमैनिटी, फॉर हिज लव फॉर मुस्लिम, फॉर हिज लव फॉर द रिवाइवल ऑफ द मुस्लिम, एंड फॉर हिज ट्रस्ट एंड लव फॉर द यूथ ऑफ द मुस्लिम. एंड ही थ्रू हिज पोइट्री ही एक्चुअली लेफ्ट द मैसेज ऑफ अल्लाह एंड द प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड मैसेज ऑफ अवेकनेस एंड अवेयरनेस. And he believed in Muslim youth, and he wanted that they should lead, and they should come forward, and they should be like Shaheen, and they should be confident. So that is all, and that is why we regard Allama Iqbal as our national poet, because this is a treasure, this is a great wealth. Wealth is not in the form of money only. Wealth, actual wealth, is in the form of wisdom, and intellect, and hope. So this is Allama Iqbal. With the passage of time, whenever, when you grow up and you develop more understanding, so you start reading Allama Iqbal side by side. There are books available which are translated into English, and also the simplification of the verses. Obviously, it was in Urdu or Persian, which may be not like easy for you, but at least translation and rest of the things are available. And he is the only poet in the world on whose work there has been a lot of research. Hundreds of books, articles are written, and people are doing their PhD, high degree in academic, on Allama Iqbal poetry, because it is full of wisdom. So people are just like, he left so much wisdom that now whom we call the scholars, the PhD scholars, it's a great thing to do. They are doing their PhD in Allama Iqbal work. You know, this is the worth of Allama, that scholars and great intellectuals are just busy translating, interpreting, finding out the meaning, what he left us with. So it's a great treasure, and we celebrate it. We owe a great deal to, and we pray Allah Almighty grant him a high place in paradise. He was blessed in this world, definitely. He would be blessed, Allah Ta'ala would bless him in the next life as well. For us is to seek guidance and spirit and hope from Allama's poetry, and learn from these great individuals who are our actual treasure. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So I hope you must have got some insight and some hope and some spirit and some liking and love for, and this is really great thing. Okay, so any question?
No, sir.
No question. Okay. We can, like, there's a, I did not realize that we've spent, okay, but it is worth spending. This is not only part of our history, but it is a part of our life in general. So it was worth spending, but I will leave you with this. We were on Sir Sayyid topic, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And we have done the services of Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. Services of Sir Sayyid, do you remember? Look, improving relationship. Improving relations. Follow me. Follow here. Improving relation, what did he do? Do you remember? Convincing British. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Convincing Muslims.
Convincing Muslims, this is what we discussed in detail, right? He wrote a pamphlet, The Loyal Mamdan of India and the Real Causes of the War of Independence. Remember?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is education service.
Yes, sir.
Did we do education service that he established school and Aligarh University and all that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, so that was his educational services. Political services? Political services?
Yes, sir, we did.
That was the, what we say, two nation theory. He was the founder of two nation theory, right? That in India there live two nation, Muslim and Hindus, and Muslim are a separate nation. So he categorized Muslim as a separate nation. Then he opposed Congress demands, you know, opposed Congress demands. Opposed Congress demands and Hindi-Urdu controversy, do you remember? Is this clear, political services?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these were Sir Sayyid services. Now, I will give you only one question here. I know, just 1 minute, give it to me. This question here, relationship, okay. See why maybe I have this, but maybe not. Okay, why did Sir Sayyid try to improve relations with Muslims? With the British. Did you understand the question?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
we discussed, sir, already that he tried to improve relationship. Now the examiner says why. So now we need to know why. I will give you the reason and I will leave you to find the description of the reason, explanation by yourself. Do you understand my point? How many reasons do we need? We need 3 reasons, right? As we discussed of 7-mark question. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
the first reason which Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan tried to improve relationship with the British was that British target Muslims after the war. And what is this target Muslim after the war? What is this that British punished Muslims severely after the war and Muslim condition was very poor and bad and Muslim considered British as the invaders who invaded India and they were responsible for all their miserable condition. And so there was a worst relationship between them and Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan believed that Muslim need to improve relationship with the British and to overcome this situation. So this is the description. Now you can find these points in the book and notes I've shared with you and you can write in here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Second reason was to uplift socio-economic status. Now we see that Muslims after the war, their situation was completely changed. They were the rulers, but now they were turned into a miserable situation. British became the rulers and Muslims were severely punished and their social economic status was totally, they were poor. So Sayyid Ahmad Khan wanted Muslims to establish good relationship with British and to get modern British education and be friend with them so that their life, their social life, their economic life in India can be improved. Do you understand? I'm giving you the brief ideas of description, so you will find the description. Third reason simply that Hindus already started improving their life, right? Improving their lives. So we'll say that Hindus quickly became friends with the British. They adjusted to the new situation, got education, and they were into jobs and other economic opportunities and political opportunities. Whereas Muslim were out of this, and they had a tension with the British, and they had a distance with the British, and Sadiq Hasan Khan wanted that if Muslim would not come forward, Hindu will take advantage and even they will subtract Muslim. So it was very important for the Muslim to establish their relationship with the British and to change their lives in India. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now I've given you the three reasons, and I've given you the brief description of this. Now from the book and from the notes, find out this question and answer. And next class, I will take an oral test of this question answer. And you have to write this question in the proper three paragraph form as well. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir,
yes.
Can
you
move a little up?
I
can. Can I take the screenshot?
Yes. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, thank sir. You very much. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz. Take care. You're a great
one.
Allah Hafiz, sir. Allah Hafiz, everyone.
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz.